Hello everyone, hope you guys doing great! My name is Dr. E and on this channel I share with you what I know on management of kennels and catteries. Today we will focus on canine reproduction, definitely my favorite. In this video we are going to talk about ovulation, artificial insemination, and when to breed to obtain the best fertility results. And to illustrate those points we are going to discuss an interesting clinical case. We will now talk about the case of Mace Windu. Spoiler alert guys, this has nothing to do with Star Wars of course, because Mace Windu is in fact a golden retriever male dog. I should even say that Mace Windu in this clinical case is a stud dog. A stud dog his owners are particularly proud of. You know, he's a beautiful dog with great temperament, great genetics. So this dog really has everything his owners ever ask for. And because of all of this, Mace Windu is in great demand. His owners recently accepted 4 requests to use him as a stud from other breeders who are living nearby. They've been breeding dogs, you know, for so long that they truly believe that they've seen it all. However, you know how this works. When breeding dogs, always expect the unexpected, right? So when they look at their messages today, this is what they see. They didn't realize it, but in fact, all 4 bitches were actually in season at the same time. And what a coincidence, look on the right. They have ovulated all of them on the exact same day. And for those of you who wonder, yes, we definitely are sticking to the Star Wars team here. So now, Mace Windu's owners are facing a dilemma. How is this going to work now? Tough situation indeed. Let's put ourselves in the shoes of the owners of those bitches. When they find out that Mace Windu is supposed to cover 4 different bitches within the same time frame, they might not be super happy. They might wonder, is this going to impact the chances of their females getting pregnant? And that would be a bummer, especially now that they just invested in a timing of ovulation to optimize their chances. And think about it, they might not be willing to change their plans at the last moment. Important fact, golden retriever females are, in average, in season every 8 to 10 months. They might not be willing to wait that long to start it all over again. And there is another important element that we need to take into account here. Because we're talking about golden retrievers, we can obviously wonder about the male's libido. I know, all males are different, but one thing we know, in this breed, well, the libido in the males is far from being exacerbated. Goldens are often described in textbooks as the poster picture of males with low libido. Will Mace Windu be willing to breed 4 bitches in a row? One might wonder. And if the owners are willing to give it a chance, one thing I can tell you for sure, they will need to strategize a bit. To make it a success here, scheduling is really key. And to be fair, this is why we do a timing of ovulation with progesterone, to better schedule things. Because remember, number one cause of infertility in canines is mistimed breeding. You do your timing, you know the day of ovulation. And remember canine reproduction 101. Bitches are very unique. After ovulation, and on the contrary to what you will find in most other mammalian species, their oocytes, or eggs, are not yet ready. Interesting element we need to add on top of that, those eggs are not ovulated at the same time. Ovulation usually occurs between 12 to 36 hours. We used to say that there is a 2-day maturation period to consider. Recent studies, however, have showed that it is a bit longer than that, more around 55-72 hours. And after they become mature, those eggs will survive around 48 hours in the uterine tubes. If you take all those elements I just mentioned into account, this is, in canines, your fertility window. There is one thing missing, however. We didn't talk yet about the sperm cell's lifespan in the genital tract of the bitch. This one is 2 days minimum. So now we have all the elements. Based on that, we can decide the most appropriate breeding plan. And very often, you know guys, you will hear that the recommendations are to breed the bitch twice, 2 and 4 days after ovulation. However, what I want to show you here is that there is no perfect schedule, so to speak. If we take into account the survival of the sperm cells in the genital tract of the bitch as well, then breeding can occur between 1 and 4 days post-ovulation. And since 2 breedings are usually recommended, you can modulate things depending on the situation. In the end, you just want to fulfill this equation. At any time, you want live sperm cells to be in contact with mature eggs. So what does this mean in our case here? 4 bitches, 8 breedings during a 4-day period? So how do we schedule this? Even with the low libido we find in goldens, breeding twice a day if you leave 4 hours between the breedings should not be too much of a problem. That is what we used to do when we were freezing semen, you know, we were collecting the males twice a day, 4 hours apart, and it always worked out great. So, in this case, here is a potential schedule. So you see, in terms of scheduling, this could potentially work out. Mace Windu's owners are definitely feeling a bit better now after we have this discussion, but one of the female's owners is about to challenge them on this. If your dog has bred other bitches, how do I know that there will be enough sperm left to impregnate mine? This is what most female owners are afraid of in a situation like this. Will the male have enough good quality sperm to impregnate the female? So let's do some math here. How many sperm cells can we find in an average ejaculate in a golden retriever? 600 to 800 millions. Remember, we don't really care about the concentration of sperm cells in dogs. What we want to know is how many sperm cells there are per ejaculate. And we want to know this because when it comes to fertilization, we know this. We know that we need at least 150 million motile sperm cells. This number is what you actually need. This is the minimum required to impregnate a female. By the way, this is what we use when we freeze semen. An inseminating dose usually contains this average number of sperm cells. Ejaculated sperm, by the way, doesn't come from the testes, but from a structure called the epididymis. This is in fact the sperm storage structure, so to speak. Every day there will be new sperm coming in, and as long as there are at least more than 150 million, there's enough to impregnate a bitch. Obviously, the first ejaculate will contain more sperm cells, but the real question is, how many sperm cells are we gonna find in the next ejaculates? With one average golden ejaculate, you could definitely impregnate 4 bitches. An ejaculate can be split in 2, 3, 4, depending on the number of sperm cells ejaculated. And that is in fact something that can be easily checked after doing a spermogram. On top of that, we now have extenders that can be used to keep the semen so that an ejaculate can be turned into multiple inseminating doses that can be kept for several days. Here, if you want to answer the question the owner of the females might have, the go-to solution would be to collect the semen, perform a spermogram, and then consider performing artificial inseminations. And actually think about this. This will open a wide new range of possibilities in a case like this. The vet collects Mace Windu on the morning and checks the number of sperm cells in his ejaculate, 960 million. This ejaculate is split in 4 inseminating doses. Extender is added, so with one ejaculate, he can cover the first 4 breedings. 2 days later, new semen collection, this time 800 million sperm cells in the ejaculate, which gives us again 4 more inseminating doses, enough to do the last 4 inseminations. One thing the owners might wonder here, is it better to perform artificial insemination versus natural breeding? Reality is, same results are to be expected, especially if we have a good timing of ovulation and good quality semen. One important thing you might wonder, is it better to do an intravaginal insemination or an intrauterine insemination? When it comes to good quality fresh semen in bitches with no history of infertility, intravaginal insemination will be enough. However, let's deep dive a little bit there. And let's start with a quick recap regarding the anatomy of the vagina of the bitch. It starts with something we call the vestibule. It communicates with the urinary tract, so any urinary disease can therefore have an impact on fertility. The vagina in itself is very long, 13 to 30 centimeters in average. And in the end, you find the cervix. This is the communication between the vagina and the uterus. And it looks like this. This is the cervix. It acts like a big filter between the vagina and the uterus. And if you want to do intrauterine insemination, well, you need to go through this. Like this. On this picture, you can see a catheter that has been inserted in the uterus. This is done under endoscopy and it is also known as TCI or transcervical insemination. This technique is especially recommended when doing frozen semen insemination I think it's an interesting option to consider in a bitch with a history of infertility, but also any time you want to optimize the fertility results. Because basically, you will bypass the filter that the cervix is, and you will allow more sperm to reach the fertilization sites at the level of the uterine tubes. In Mace Windu's case here, this is something that could be considered for sure, and that's what was done here. A month later, you know, Mace Windu's owners received ultrasound pictures. The four bitches were pregnant, with very decent litter size. Remember at the beginning, this case sounded like a dilemma. However, it shows you that, with a bit of planning and strategy, we can definitely make it work. And let me reassure you here, this is definitely not a common situation. Mace Windu's case is really an exception. The goal of this video is really to show you, well, that things can be done when you have a good understanding of the physiology of reproduction in canines, and of the tools you have at your disposal. And that's all for today, guys, but you know what? Stay tuned, because more is to come. After all, we're talking about my favorite topic here, so there are still plenty of things I want to share with you.